Hi, this is JJ Johansson on Off TV. I'm gonna take you on a trip around Paris to show you places that has meant a lot to me during my career and my private life.
It was in France where everything started to happen, really. Whiskey was released in France in the beginning of 97, and my success in Sweden was very small, but it instantly became pretty big here in France. So I started spending so much time here in France, and it was really in France and especially in Paris where I, for the first time in my life, encountered a lot of fans. And we have a special relationship, the French fans and me. Mr. Fredrickson.
Here we are outside Paris Jazz Corner.
Yeah, I've been spending a lot of time behind these blue doors and blue windows here we see. I came here to Paris to run to this place to see if I could find some other old Chet Baker things I hadn't. I think for me, jazz music has always been my major influence in the songwriting part, in the lyrics and the melodies. When it comes to the arrangement and production, that's where more modern influences take part, especially in the beat. One part of the arrangements is also very influenced by soundtracks, like especially, in the beginning I was very much into the John Barry soundtracks of the James Bond films, or Ennio Morricone, or even Bernard Herrmann for the Hitchcock films. I know I got some
problems. We are in front of a place called Le Temple, a place that is very important to me because this is where we had, my wife and me, had our wedding celebration. I used to go to church as a kid. I mean, my parents took us to church, but since I moved away from home, I visit churches more and more seldom, sure.
We are outside the Galerie Emmanuel Perrotin. I used to go to art school. I never thought that music would be possible to have a career in. I thought more that it would be possible to work with something related to art for me. So my education is actually art. Then when I had a music career happening here in Paris and in France, the first thing I did was to visit all the galleries and to go to all the art shows and the vernissage. Of course, it's important to know about the classic composers, but I think it's much more interesting to see what these new teenagers are releasing on internet today. And it's the same in the art world. So my relationship to Paris really grew very big in 99 and 2000. And then the Poison Tour in 2000 became possibly my biggest tour ever. That tour in France, and the last concert of the Poison Tour was at Élysée Montmartre, the 20th November, year 2000. One of the most magic moments of my career. After the gig here, I decided to try something else, and that I had to change and had to move in a direction that I didn't know what would happen. Here we are, just a couple of meters down the road from Élysée Montmartre at Trianon. I've already planned a concert in December at the Trianon this year for my new album Cockroach that comes in September. So it's really amazing. It's just the next block. One of the most beautiful venues I've been playing, I have to say, here in Paris. I mean, of course, Olympia is nice as well, and Cigale as well. Cigale down the road there, but Trianon is fantastic too.